So Carlo, if you had to fight Manny or you had to fight Mayweather, how do you fight them?
Well, with Mayweather, you need a steady attack. You know, I mean, you got to. I mean, what I see is Jose Luis Castillo when they fought him as lightweights, first fight, I thought Castillo won, and that's exactly how I would fight him. Except, you know, I was a body puncher. I would break him in half. I mean, I would just be digging his body like.
You fought at 47, right?
I fought at 147, yeah. And my whole career, I was 147. So, my specialty was my left hook to the body, and that's where I would be going. And, you know, staying away from that, his defensive skill of getting away from right hands. But I'm on him with left hooks, you know, constantly working the body, and then hoping that in later rounds, defense will come, hands will come down, and then I can get him on top. With Manny, also pressure because he's also, you know, he's got great foot speed, moves around a lot, and I think that with a good jab and a good stick jab, you can get in behind the jab with the right hand, left hooks, work the body up and down. That's the only way to beat these guys. You have to be in great shape. And you have to be able to throw punches nonstop every round. You know, that's the way I did it as an amateur, and that's how I did it as a pro. So. That's what I think it would take to beat him. And that's how I would fight him. Constant pressure.
A lot of people in boxing that I talk to favor Mayweather. You're favoring Manny. Yeah. Why do you think so many people are favoring Floyd? Because he's undefeated? Because
I think that's a big case. He's undefeated, and he's such a great defensive fighter. You know, and he's hard to hit. But you know, is going to talk to the referee about the holding too, because I think he holds a lot. And if they make sure that the referee is aware that they're going to be looking at that, maybe the referee will step in and not allow him to hold as much, and it'll make it a better fight. You know?
Let me ask you about one more fight. Canelo Kirkland, it's a week after Mayweather Pacquiao, so Canelo Alvarez, you're very familiar with him, of course. Kirkland, 31 wins, 28 by knockouts, and I think only one loss.
Yeah, you know, I don't know Kirkland very well. I haven't seen him fight too much. I love Canelo's style, you know. So I really can't comment on the fight because I don't know Kirkland very well.
What makes Canelo at age 24 one of the most popular superstars in boxing?
Well, because, you know, we've kind of run out of extra stars. And, he's basically the only guy right now, and Mexican fans love Mexican fighters, especially they love warriors, and he's a warrior. And we don't have any stars right now. He's the only one, and we're all going to back him, you know, no matter what. And I know Kirkland has a lot of knockouts. We'll see. I think that's going to be a very interesting fight. Tough fight for both guys.
Last thing I got to tell you. So all week, Ricky Funes over here, he's been getting a lot of keyboard warriors. You know what those are? No, people who talk smack online. So Ricky put a challenge out there. Anybody who talks smack about him is welcome to come here and spar him. So far, no one has showed up. Well, how do you think Ricky would do when they do show up?
Well, no, I mean, that's why nobody's showing up. They know what they're going to compete against. Come on. and I would recommend don't show up.
Have you ever sparred him?
No. He's got a world champion right
now.
No.
No, Ricky's a youngster, man.
I'm young. I just turned 38.
Yeah. You are young.
He looks even younger than me.
He's doing movies now.
Yeah, they're doing a big thing for his movie.
Is it your life story? Your autobiography?
We're doing my life story. I got a deal with a production company where we're getting the first draft of the script. We're going to start to go out and find somebody that can play me at a young age. Hopefully we can find a great actor like Duane Phillips. They found him for La Bamba. So that's what we're looking forward to.
What's his name?
You said Morales?
What's his name? William Levy.
Diamond Phillips.
How about who's the guy that boxes that I want to spar? Mario Lopez.
Mario Lopez. I think you forget his name, man.
Because he's been ducking me for 2 years, so. But that's huge. That's a big deal.
Yeah, Ellie, is it you ducking him?
I don't duck anybody. I'll spar you right now.
See, you want to hurt me. You really want to embarrass me?
No, I don't want to
embarrass you. You want to embarrass me?
No. Let me ask you this. You once told me, check this out, Ricky. You once told me about your sparring session with the greatest fighter, Jose Napoli. People say he's the greatest fighter in the history of Mexico. What happened when you sparred? Tell Ricky this story.
Oh, my God.
You got to hear this one.
Yeah, so I get to the gym, and I'm second in line to get in the ring. And he's sparring with a guy that back in the 70s, young Cassius. He was a lightweight, young Cassius play. And he was fast and just scrafty itself. And the first round, bam, Monopolis drops him, gets him with a hook, drops him. He's standing over him, nah, get up, and he hits you that hard. And so and I'm next. And I'm a young amateur. I haven't had my first pro fight yet. I'm waiting to have my first pro fight. I'm scared as hell. And I idolize Jose Monopolis. And so I get in the ring. And first round went okay. I'm throwing a thousand punches a second. Scared. He's just walking me down. You know, you remember his style? He's just like
walking down.
Yeah, just walking me down. And then the second round it starts, and bam, he catches him with a. I threw a jab. And he slipped it and cut me right up, cut right under the cheekbone. Right there, buckle me. I went on the ropes. My trainer, Noe Cruz, very smart guy. He jumped right in the middle. Okay, that's enough.
Got you out.
They walked me
that's
right
the smartest
out.
Thing.
Yeah, got me out.
Why damage you, you know?
Yeah. Yeah, and then I went to meet him, of course, right? So we go after he's done, and he's telling me, oh, he's coming from here. Yeah, my wife gives me better smarter than that. That's what he said. Wow.
Did you ever
held
a grudge against him?
Oh, no. What happened? So he loses the title tournament to John Stracy. I go to London and knock John Stracy out. I come back. I get invited to Mexico City, and I go see Jose Napolis. He has a bar. And he calls me up on the stage, and we're talking.
Oh, really?
Yeah, and I tell him the story. He didn't remember that he did that.
He did it to you.
It was a regular thing for him.
Yeah, people don't remember.
Yeah, but he was... He was very humble when I came back with the title and thanked me for winning the title back.
How old were you at that time?
I was 26 years old.
And how was Napolis?
Napolis was, I think, almost 50.
He was Cuban, right?
Yeah.
And he came in. EsNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Secback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Secback. And you can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Secback.